For today's top entertainment story, Thursday, the 18th of February, I'm Simone Robinson. You Roy, legendary reggae toaster, dies aged 78. All coming up after the break.
Gotta let the world know how much I need to know. Should I want the world to know?
The legendary toaster, U-Roy, has died aged 78. A representative for Trojan Records has confirmed. No cause of death has been made public. The British reggae DJ David Rodigan was among those to pay tribute, describing U-Roy as the paradigm of Jamaican music. I was always in awe of him. The tone of voice, the cadence, the lyrical shimmering, and rhythm writing made him the sole adventurer. Ollie Campbell of UB40 hailed him as a true inspiration, paving the way for many generations and creating a sound that will live forever. Shaggy said, "Today we lost one of our heroes." The rapper Ghost Poet tweeted, "They ain't ready for your toasting in heaven." U-Roy was not the first toaster, but he became known as the originator for being the first to put his distinctive vocal style on record, birthing a phenomenon and inspiring the creation of hip-hop. His rich-toned voice proclaimed sizzling, jive-saturated lyrics rather than simply inserting a few phrases, wrote a critic for Reggae Vibes, and besides that he rode the pared-down instrumental track all the way through, rather than interjecting at crucial points. U-Roy was born York Beckford in Kingston, Jamaica in 1942. His family was musical, his mother performing in the choir at a local Seventh-day Adventist church. He first DJed aged 14. "My mother used to say to me, 'Why don't you trim and shave because you will look a much nicer boy,' he told United Reggae. "And I used to say, 'Listen, Mom, I did not tell you not to be a Seventh-day Adventist. I did not tell you not to play that organ on that choir. I'm going to do what I have to do, and I'm not going to disrespect you. But what I believe in is what I believe in." He began his professional career in 1961. Performing on the sound system owned by Dickie Wong, who ran the Tit for Tat record label and club where Sly Dunbar met Robbie Shakespeare in Kingston. He moved between sound systems before a period as the top DJ of King Tubby's hometown Hi-Fi in the late 60s. King Tubby's elongated dub versions created the space for U-Roy to expand his inventive vocal style. "That's when things started picking up for me." In Bob Stanley's Pop History Yeah Yeah Yeah, singer Dennis Al Capone describes witnessing the duo play live. Him and U-Roy start the dance off as normal. And after a while he play You Don't Care by the Techniques. Then he switch it to the dub version and, after a couple of lines, all the crowd could hear was pure rhythm. Then U-Roy come in toasting. And they went nuts. In 1969 U-Roy made his first recordings with Keith Hudson, Lee Perry and Peter Tosh, though his breakout would come a year later. When John Holt witnessed U-Roy DJing and toasting over Holt's song, "Were You to the Ball," and told producer Duke Reed to work with him, their partnership spawned three immediate hits, "Wake the Town," "Rule the Nation," and "Were You to the Ball," as well as two dozen more singles, and inspired a rush of producers seeking to work with DJs on record. Before that, the DJ business was not something that people take seriously. He told the LA Times, "I didn't really took it serious. People weren't really used to this stuff." U-Roy released hundreds of singles throughout the 70s, including a run of hits with Bunny Lee. In 1975, Hall and Oates covered his hit Soldering, leading to a deal for the DJ with Virgin and the album Dread in a Babylon, produced by Prince Tony Robinson. It boosted U-Roy's popularity in the UK, where he counted Joe Strummer as a fan. On the other side of the Atlantic, DJ Kool Herc and Coke Law Rock took the approach of U-Roy and the Kingston sound to their Bronx parties to distinguish them from the mid-70s disco scene, extemporizing over space echo and inventing their own slang. Kool Herc's Bronx apartment block would come to be recognized as the birthplace of hip-hop. Undeterred by his recording success, U-Roy returned to sound system culture, launching his own Sturgav to raise a new generation of toasters including Shabaranks, Ranking Joe, and Charlie Chaplin. "That was the biggest fun in my life when I started doing this. While active as a performer in the 1980s, Uroy scarcely recorded again until 1991, by which time he had moved to LA when the British producer, Mad Professor, invited him to appear on the album True Born African. It spawned another lasting creative partnership. Uroy's last album, 2018's Talking Roots, was also produced by Mad Professor. From I was 15 when I heard Version Galore, I wanted to work with Uroy, Mad Professor tweeted on Thursday. In 2019, he was crowned by Shabba Ranks in New York, who called him the Picasso of our music. That year he also recorded a new album, Gold, The Man Who Invented Rap, featuring Sly and Robbie, Zach Starkey on guitar, and Youth of Killing Joke on production, with guest appearances from Mick Jones of The Clash, Santi Gold, Shaggy, and Ziggy Marley, among others. A release date is planned for the summer. Reflecting on his message, Uroy told the LA Times, I just talk about unity with people. I don't really try to put down people or anything like that. Violence is very ugly, and love is very lovely. I never been to college or anything like that. But I have some common sense. And what I learn, I just make the best of it, you know. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And send us an email of your stories to pvptvuk24@gmail.com.